Hey everybody, welcome back to Banjo-Kazooie. This is going to be the first of two bonus videos. In the last video, we defeated Gruntilda in the final boss fight, we saw the ending and all that stuff. In this video, we're going to cover an optional mode. Like, you don't have to do it, but it's something fun I wanted to show. And it's the Bottles Bonus Puzzle minigame. By doing this, you get some codes that alter Banjo and Kazooie's appearances. Doesn't really do anything other than that, but, you know, it's something fun to mess around with, but anyway. To start this out, all you have to do is go back to Spiral Mountain and go back to Banjo's house. Okay, we're in Banjo's house and all you have to do is look at this picture of Bottles. You have to get really close to it, like if you're too far away it won't work. But once you get close enough, he'll start talking to you and he'll talk about his moving picture minigame. There's several puzzles to complete. They start getting more difficult as it goes along. This first one is actually really easy. I'm just letting you know in advance, the control stick on my Xbox 360 controller is really sensitive, so like when you move it around, it's not that accurate. It moves around a little faster than I would like, but you know, it's still good enough to do this puzzle. Okay, this one takes place in Banjo's house. There's some later puzzles that require some rotations of the pieces. This one requires no rotations whatsoever. That and a lot of the pieces are actually near the spot where they're supposed to be. Oops. Yeah, that's that's more control stick shenanigans there. Okay, so that was easy. And that was the first puzzle. But yeah, after you clear each one, Bottles will give you a code to put in Treasure Trove Cove's sandcastle. If you remember, it has all the letters on the floor. Then you just put in all these passwords. I'll show what all of them do later on. Okay, it's time for the second puzzle. This one is a little bit more difficult. It's still pretty easy, but this one, I believe, requires some rotations. Also, you'll notice that, you know, Banjo is moving around a lot. You can actually use that to your advantage, because as you can see on the puzzle pieces, you know, you can see where he is and where other characters are and, you know, parts of the room that Banjo and Kazooie are in. So you can use that to help you out as well. Here it's actually pretty useful, like that piece I just put down. Banjo was moving around there. You actually get plenty of time to put these pieces down. Later on, you know, as the puzzles get more difficult, you actually have less time. The last puzzle, you get like a very limited amount of time to complete it. Like in that case, there's not a lot of room for error. Okay, last piece. There we go. Okay, and here is the second password, Bottles Bonus 2. Again, I'll show all the codes all together at the very end of the video. Okay, time for puzzle number 3. Okay, this one requires a few rotations. You can actually see some of the pieces there. Rotated before they ended up on the sides. This one is a little bit more difficult because there's parts of this room that we're this is in Rusty Bucket Bay. It's kind of dark, so, you know, like this piece I just picked up, it's really dark, so it's kind of harder to see. Again, like with the previous two puzzles, the placement of Banjo and NPCs and items, stuff like that, use that to your advantage to see where they are, so you can put the puzzle pieces down in the right spots. Hi. Jeez, Banjo's getting really beat up in this, this puzzle scene here. I'm surprised he's not dead yet. But yeah, you can actually go do these puzzles once you unlock, I think, Treasure Trove Cove, and you beat that. But, you know, obviously you don't get access to some of these later ones until you get to these worlds, from what I remember. Like, you can't do this one until you beat Rusty Bucket Bay. But I never really messed around with these until I beat the game. There's not much of a reason to do these, you know, sooner than later, unless you want to mess around with the codes. Okay, time for stage 4. Okay, as you can see here, this one takes place in Click Clock Wood. This one, kind of like the previous one, it's kind of dark in this room, so it's a little bit more difficult. Doesn't look like there's a lot of movement here either. And as you can see, this one requires quite a few pieces to be rotated. And watching this back now, it's like, I know where that goes. But yeah, even though this one requires a lot of rotations, you still get a really good amount of time. Yeah, look, see, I'm making a lot of errors here, and no, I still have plenty of time. Oh yeah, I was trying to figure out how to put the pieces back. I couldn't figure it out. I was mashing buttons. Look, even with that, I still have a good amount of time left and very few pieces to put away. I was a little panicky here though, because I was like, oh. There we go. Had 6 seconds to spare. Okay, bottles bonus 4, that is the next password. So you could probably see a pattern here with the passwords. Not all of them are going to be like that. I think the last two are different from what I remember. Okay, stage 5. Okay, this one, even though this is, you know, 5 puzzles into the whole minigame series, I think this one's really easy. It helps that the Tip Top Choir is here, so you can kind of tell, like, because they have different colored shells, so it really helps out. One more. There we go. But yeah, this is in Bubble Gloop Swamp. This is not one of my favorite worlds in the game, but it wasn't that bad from what I played. For those of you that watched that video, I mentioned that, you know, when I was a kid and I played that world, I really hated it. And the worst part of it wasn't as bad as I remember. The Mr. Vile minigame, I think that's his name. Yeah, see? It's not that bad. Yeah, you can see on the bottom pieces the, was that purpley colored shell? It's very easy to see where that piece goes. There we go. So yeah, I think that one was a little bit easier than the previous one. Okay, so that's 5 down, and according to bottles, there's just one more level left. Okay, stage 6. This is in Mad Monster Mansion, and as you can see, a lot of the pieces rotated, so you're gonna have to rotate almost all of them, really. As you can see, it's another puzzle that has dark pieces. Or, not dark pieces, but the room itself is dark, so, you know, the pieces end up being dark, for the most part. Looks like that did go there. There we go. But yeah, not much to say about this one. I mean, as long as you pay attention to parts of the background, like right here, the ghost is flying around. It's like, oh, that goes up there. Yeah, see, that's really helpful right there when the ghost is really up close. Yeah, why is it that Banjo is always getting beat up in these scenes here? Alright, last piece. Yeah, not too bad. Okay, big bottles bonus. So it's not bottles bonus, was that 6 or whatever? Okay. He claims we have no other games to play. But yeah, there's another one. This one is difficult because it requires a lot of rotations. The background in this one is kind of hard to see because it's kind of samey. And you only get 75 seconds to do this puzzle. Okay, but yeah, since you only have 75 seconds, you have to make pretty much every piece count. I mean, if you can memorize where all these go, it helps, but you know, I can't memorize stuff like that. I mean, there's like a couple pieces that I remember, but yeah, this one took me, I think, 5 tries total, because I kept running out of time. I think there were a few times in those attempts where I'd be holding the last piece, and I'd hold it right up to the spot where it was supposed to go, but I ran out of time because I, you know, made too many mistakes. But yeah, as you can see here, this is what I'm talking about. I think the background is kind of the same for the most part, because you have like the honey floor and the honeycomb walls and stuff. I mean, there is some room for error, like a little bit of room. I mean, I've made quite a few mistakes already. But yeah, that's the main thing with this one, the time. Just gotta do it really fast. And there we go. Last piece with 5 seconds to spare. And if you do all these on the Xbox 360 version, you get an achievement. So that is something that you can get if you're into that kind of stuff. I'm not really, but that's the last code, Wishy Washy Banjo. That one sounds a lot different than the other codes. And I'll show what that one does at the end. But yeah, now that we have all the codes, we're going to exit here and, well, eventually exit here and head back to Treasure Trove Cove. Okay, we're back here at Treasure Trove Cove, so let's head in. Okay, as always, what you want to do is drain the moat. To do that, you have to fill Leaky with these eggs, then he'll drain the moat for you, and then you can head into the sandcastle. Okay, now that we're inside the sandcastle, the first thing you want to do is take care of this crab. You guys probably remember this one from before. Oh, just watch out. But yeah, once he's gone, he'll never respawn until you exit the world, so. Anyway, this is the floor where we entered the code. I think Banjo-Kazooie was written on the wall. You got a puzzle piece by doing that the first time. And this is where you enter any code in the game. There are other codes that aren't going to be covered in this video. There's a lot of codes in this game. Most of them are just like, you know, refill items or whatever. But here we're going to enter the first password. So it was bottles bonus 1. Yeah, this one I'm going to play at regular speed, but when we get to the other codes, I'm just going to speed it up. But yeah, there's dozens and dozens of codes for this game. I'm not going to cover them. Some of them I would only recommend using at your own risk, because if you put in too many of them, then it could delete your save file, and you know, that's why I don't really mess with those codes. But those aren't found in the game, you have to look those up online. Okay, bottles bonus 1, this is what this does. So it gives Banjo a giant head, and all of these codes change Banjo-Kazooie's appearances. His head is ridiculously big. Okay, and to get rid of this code, all you have to type in is no bonus. I'm just gonna skip that after this one. Okay, and he's back to normal. So, as far as I know, in order to type in more codes, you have to exit the sandcastle and then go back in, because as you can see, stomping on the bee isn't doing anything. Okay, next up is Bottles Bonus 2. Inputting this code gives Banjo giant hands and giant feet. This also looks ridiculous. All of these look ridiculous, really. Okay, I bet Bottles likes this one. Bottles Bonus 3 gives Kazooie a giant head. You know, the first code gave Banjo the giant head, now this one gives Kazooie a giant head. And this one looks ridiculous when you're using Kazooie to attack because it just looks really painful for the enemies involved. Okay, Bottles Bonus 4. This one is really weird. You know, the other ones, it gave, like, enlarged body parts. This one just kind of stretches Banjo. And he, just looks really bad. Oh, it also gives him this, like, weird effect on his head. It's like, I don't know, it's like, it almost looks like it's inflating and deflating, I don't know. Okay, Bottles Bonus 5, it's kind of like a combination code. It gives you the effect of Bottles Bonus 4 with like the stretch body, but it also gives him giant hands and giant feet. So, yeah, like I said, it's basically a combination code, really. But yeah, this looks ridiculous. I mean, imagine this running at an enemy. Okay, Big Bottles Bonus. This is the sixth code, and this pretty much just makes them giant, really. Got a giant head, giant feet, giant hands, Kazooie's head is big, but, you know, just like all the other codes, they look ridiculous. Okay, and here is the last code, Wishy Washy Banjo. This is the most infamous code out of all of them, really. But it transforms Banjo into a washing machine. I don't remember if this showed up during the playthrough, but Mumbo can randomly turn you into this form when he's trying to change you into, like, you know, one of the other forms that are actually in the game. But yeah, when you're in this form, Banjo is just a washing machine. And Kazooie is just non-existent. I mean, you could still do her attacks, but, you know, she doesn't show up. And this is ridiculous. I mean, I'm gonna do some gameplay of this one, as you'll see in a moment, but it just looks so silly. Okay, again, to change them back into the regular forms, just type in no bonus on the sandcastle floor, and they'll be back as regular Banjo-Kazooie. Well, that is pretty much it for this video. This was just a bonus video to show those codes, because, you know, that's, again, not required in the game. You don't get any percentage. I mean, you do get an achievement if you're playing on the Xbox 360 or Xbox One version of the game, but other than that, it's just something to do for fun. Just, you know, something I wanted to show. Anyway, the next bonus video is going to cover the stop and swap feature, which I've never messed with because that wasn't fully implemented in the Nintendo 64 version, so that's new to the Xbox 360 version. So yeah, that'll be covered next time. I'm actually looking forward to that because as of this recording, I haven't done any of that stuff yet, so I'm going to try that out, record it in this file, and then that'll be it for the bonus videos in this playthrough. Okay, everybody, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.